So hello guys, this is Vinod, and in today's sessions about statistics background for forecasting, we will touch upon some of the terms. So we'll talk about what is a time series is, and we will also talk about the forecast error, which is also known as residual. Yeah, we started. So what is a time series? So time series says, let's say you have different time period, right? So you have T1 as a timestamp, T2, T3, T4, T5, and so on till time n, right? So you have, on these different time intervals, we have a observed value. So y represent the observed value at T1 point timestamp. And same goes for y2, y3, y4 at different time intervals, and same goes for yn. So basically, we have different values at different time intervals, right, in a consecutive manner. That's a time series. So when you take values in the, you know, at different time intervals in a successive manner, that is called as time series. Now let's understand what is a forecast versus forecast, or you can say forecast or your predicted value. Yeah. So before we do this, as I said, y represents your observed value. Yeah. So that's a, the small y represents your observed value, and the capital Y represents the forecasted value for our understanding purpose. Yeah. So let's say, and the dollar sign represents the forecast lead time, right? And the forecast lead time, as we know, and if you don't know, please watch my earlier videos where I have talked about, what is the forecast lead time. But let's say today, right? Today, if you want to make a prediction for tomorrow, right? Then we have a one day as a forecast lead time, because today we are predicting for tomorrow. So we have a forecast lead time of one day, right? So let's say if dollar represents, that's one day, right? That you forecast lead time. Then at certain time t, we may have a actual value which is represented as yt, small y in t. And if you go back in time, so let's say if we go, you know, one day prior at t minus dollar, right? Because we'll be predicting the value for tomorrow, today, right? And for today, you may have used the value for yesterday, right? So if yt is your actual value, so for this you have to go back one day prior, right? So that's where t minus dollar will be your, I would say, the time, right? That's when you will capture the value, what's going to be the forecast value at time t, right? So this is the observed value on at time t, which is actual value, and this is a fitted value basis, which is predicted at this time t minus dollar, which is represented as y, capital Y, which is a predicted value at t minus dollar. Yeah, so that's the actual value versus the fitted value. Now let's again understand this in detail. So let's say you have a lead time minus one, right? So for example, as I said, I mean, today if you want to make a prediction, so you will use previous day data, which is you're going, you know, minus one, right? One day prior. That's a lead time minus one. Say, let's say, so t is your current time, and t minus one is your previous time, historical data. Where the yt shows the actual value, and yt, the capital Y, t minus one shows the forecasted value, because using the making the prediction for time t at t minus one, right? So that's the forecasted value. Now we understood what is a actual value and what is a forecasted value. Let's go detail and understand what is a forecastic error. So forecastic error is nothing but at certain time t, right? Considering this lead time, there's a difference between your yt, the actual value, right, and minus the predicted value, which has been predicted at t minus that lead time. So that value is known as the difference between these two, your observed value and the forecasted value, is known as forecast error. Right. So let's say again going back to the same example we have taken. If we take one day prior data to predict for today, so here the lead time is one. Right. So that's why it's one here, and et minus et one, and this is yt, and capital Y, which is a predictive value at t minus one time. Right. Again, as I said, the difference between the YT, the actual value, and the observed value at taken as t minus one is known as your error and residual. Yeah. So I think I hope you'll be able to understand what is a time series is, and how do we calculate the forecast error, which is also known as residual, from this video. So guys, so if you like my videos, please provide your comment in my video. And please stay tuned, because I'll be covering a lot of interesting topics in my videos. And so thank you guys for watching it, and have a good day. Bye bye.